Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is amazing Quran in which I share with you what I find amazing in the Holy Quran. There is a verse in Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 56, in which Allah said, "Kullama nazijat juluduhum baddallahum juludan ghayraha liyadhuqul azab." Allah says over here that the people will be thrown into the hellfire. And in the hellfire, when the hellfire will burn their skins, they will be given the new skins. كُلَّمَا نَضِجَتْ جُلُودُهُمْ بَدَّلَّهُمْ جُلُودًا غَيْرَهَا. Allah will give the new skin. So a question arises over here in mind that when Allah has thrown them into the hellfire, so that's enough. They should be there in that condition and they should suffer the hellfire constantly and they should remain in punishment. Why Allah is changing the skins again and again there? So recently the science has proved that the anatomy of skin says that there are layers in our skins. When your skin is half burnt, only then you feel the pain, because the sensory receptors are there in the lowest layer of the skin. And if all the layers of the skin will be burned and the sensory receptors will be damaged, a person will become feelingless. And obviously the purpose of throwing a person into the hellfire is to make him feel the pain. That's why this verse says that whenever the skins will be burned and the fire will reach the last layer of the skin, then and there Allah will give them the new skins. And Allah says in this verse why it is happening, لِيَزُوقُ الْعَذَابِ, so that they taste the azab, they taste the pain of their torment. So obviously for a person it was impossible 1400 years ago to make such verses, and it is the word of someone who is the creator of the human body. And just because of this one verse, a skin specialist in Thailand accepted Islam and he said, "I can't believe that anyone had so much knowledge about the human body 1400 years ago that he could make such a kalam, such a word and such a verse. It is really the word of Allah. Subhanallah, it strengthens our iman that Quran is really from God."